There's a lot of talk these days about SEL, social emotional learning. But what exactly is it? Social emotional learning is the process of learning social and emotional skills, and it's just as important as learning reading or math. This learning process is most effective when it begins early and continues through high school. Social emotional skills are essential for success in school, work, and life. With SEL, students learn to manage their own emotions and behaviors, have empathy and show care and concern for others, solve problems effectively, make responsible decisions, and maintain healthy relationships. Students learn to recognize what's happening inside them and to be aware of their emotions, which helps them deal with strong emotions and impulsive behaviors. It helps them stop, take a breath, and think about a situation before acting. Students learn to identify others' emotions and perspectives, which helps them empathize and show compassion, no matter who they are or what their background is. It's not difficult to imagine how this is important in the classroom and in life. Students learn to solve problems in peaceful ways and communicate assertively about what they need or want. This helps them get along with other students and get the help they need from adults. When students learn to make responsible decisions about their lives and their future, things can turn out better. Just as important, students who are socially and emotionally competent have more friends. This means they're more likely to feel connected to school and do well, and less likely to be left out or bullied. Simply put, by participating in social-emotional learning, students learn the skills to succeed in every facet of school and the rest of their lives.
So today we're going to talk to some fourth graders about self-awareness and also social awareness. Students that are self-aware, they recognize what their strengths are, they recognize what their weaknesses are or some challenges that they might have and how they approach those challenges. Instead of getting upset and mad about it, they understand and identify how they need to work through it. Self-awareness also makes it easier for students to build self-esteem in themselves and also helps them speak up for what they want or what they need.
If you see a friend and they're having a really hard time, how can you encourage them?
You could say that, like, don't worry, you can't do it yet.
I could help them on the hard things. I would say not to give up and try again.
What are you most proud about?
What I'm proud of myself is I get A's in school. I'm trying hard and doing my best.
When we were going to, like, America, I cannot talk, like, English, but I know a little bit of it, better and better.
Reading?
Tell me more about it.
Read the book. I don't know how to, like, really read when I, like, come in Egypt, when I come in here. So I just know ABC and 1, 2, 3, 2, 10. And then when I come here, I know I go to ESL and I, when I come here, I know how to read and write.
What is something that you do when you're upset or angry about something and it helps you feel better?
I either go sit in my room,
okay,
and watch TV,
okay,
or I go on with Miss Dela Cruz and we do fun stuff like drawing pictures and learning how to breathe.
Play with my little brother or hug him.
Who in your life can make you laugh?
My dad when he tickles me.
My dad.
The person in my life that makes me laugh is my dad and my sister Sarah.
My mom.
Family makes me happy when we have a game night every, like, day we get off.
My life makes me laugh is my brother Noah and my friend Alana.
Mom and dad and my little sister.
My little brother and my best friend Haley.
Mom and dad and my sister and also my granny.
Is it important to know who can make you laugh and who can make you happy?
They help, like, cheer us up when we're upset.
It's important because when you're sad and you don't know, like, what to do, then you'll have someone to cheer you up or make you happy.
My family is important because they play with me and make me happy and they make me laugh.
What is an important quality about a good friend?
When you're sad, a friend can help you.
A good friend is a friend forever and a person who never leaves you alone in trouble.
A good friend must have
kindness, generosity.
What I think must be a good friend have, they're kind, they look for other people's feelings.
A good quality of a good friend is someone who respects you.
What is one thing about yourself that you want to improve on?
I want to get better at my writing. And the reason why I want to get better at that is because I have like really sloppy writing, and I'm going to learn from Miss Smolzy and Miss Esposito to learn how to write properly.
Are you going to get better at writing? What do you need to do to get better?
Just a practice writing.
I would like to get better is writing more difficulty words, because sometimes I'm writing word in an essay, I might get stuck with it, or I write it a different way. Sometimes I might erase it, the sentence doesn't make sense.
Thank you to all the fourth graders who shared their time and their experience with us. Being self-aware is the first step in understanding of who you are as a person and what great qualities you have to offer the world today and as you grow older.
As you can see, not only is reading, writing, arithmetic, science, and social studies important for your education, what also is important is how you feel and how you deal with your emotions and how you go through life maintaining those positive relationships and also being able to go through the negative ones, and how to make sure that you are in a safe environment, and also giving you the power to achieve all of your goals. However, you will not be able to do that unless you learn the skills to be able to get to where you would like to be. So, that is why we are focusing on social-emotional learning today, on Friday, March 26th, 2021.